my first question straight away is, for the benefit of our festival delegates, how did the idea of directing Marycom come in? You know, what was the point when you decided that you wanted to portray a living character on screen?
It's actually a very funny situation. Okay. My background has been acting, you know, and being on theater, stage, plays throughout my childhood. And while growing up, yes, you go on to, you know, seeing the world cinema and different stories around the world. And you figure out and you think that why are they not being done over here, you know? And while I was art directing, I mean, that was one, another thing that I still do, as in I art direct movies and shows and films and everything. While doing that, I got this idea that why shouldn't I direct? Because yes, I am into acting. Okay, I have stopped acting, but I can make an actor act. Why? Mm-hmm. Not because I've learned direction. No, because I can act. So I can tell the front person how to act, you know. And while writing scripts, I have written lots of scripts earlier when I was simultaneously doing art direction. And they were just over the top, like my sets that I do, the drama, the, you know, I thought that I would make a Moulin Rouge and, you know, beautiful, huge sets, which incorporates my kind of stuff. And if you see, my office also is so crazy, you know. But while doing that, it so happened that, okay, I'm a first-time director. Who would, you know, entrust me in, because I've not learned direction, how would I go about it? So me and my writer, Saivin Quadris, where he was working with me, and we started writing. We had written different scripts and all. But it was not gelling, you know, with the actors. Maybe it's for me, but not for the actors. Then we thought, okay, what is world cinema all about? Art telling true stories, which in India was not a, you know, a genre at that time. And it so happened that something, if as I think as an actor, if a role is given to me, which is my life's best role, and that will be a stamp with me throughout my life, I would love to do as an actor. So we thought the other way, you know, let's give the actor something that he can not say no to, you know. And while doing that, okay, we researched quite a lot. Okay, what are the things that are working? Because India, different times, different things work, okay. And it's like a genre that comes in and everyone goes into that line. At that time, biopics was not part of it. In fact, Bhag Milka Bhag was not released at that time. They hadn't been signed when I started thinking about this. Okay, so first and of all, we thought, okay, we need a fantastic idea. What is the idea? So we looked up on different you know, roles in the sense, Rani Lakshmi Bai, a queen, Dinah, everything, all possible. Why female-oriented? Okay, because all the actors were taken and they were very busy. That's like, you know, getting to know that, okay, if I approach a female, she might say yes to me at that time, okay? And because, yes, they're all friends of mine, we work together, but I, as an art director, have worked with them, you know? So why would they come to me? So, okay, my writer, Simon, came up with different ideas, and finally, he just came up with, why not Marycom? I said, okay, I've heard something about Marycom. Who is she? You know, it's like, then I said, but it's interesting, okay? Why? Because she's in boxing. Here in India, nobody had done female boxing at all. Okay. So that's a first for me. And I wanted to stand out from the clutter. I wanted my movie to stand out from the shelf. Like, okay, this is a thing that nobody's done before. And yes, if nobody's done before, so I don't need to ask anyone how to direct this. It's up to me. You know, so that was the first. And once we started reading about her, and she's a 5-time world boxing champion and nobody knows about it, that got me excited.